on Family Matters.
Happy holidays!
All right, it's that time of year when everybody's in a good mood. We're toasting the holiday season tonight, live at 5.
Now, from the ATV News Center at every city and town in the Maritimes, this is the ATV Evening News, live at 5.
Good evening, everybody, and welcome to the Christmas Eve edition of Live at 5. I'm Nancy Regan.
And I'm Bill Justman. As you can see behind us, oh, there's a load of great friends here.
Give us
to
a wave,
help us
guys.
Celebrate this Christmas Eve. Hey, wave, everybody.
That's right.
Right.
And some of our friends happen to be very musically inclined. We're delighted to be joined tonight by the Nova Scotia Mass Choir. We'll be hearing some terrific tunes.
Oh, yeah, and you know, Santa Claus and I go way back into the Jurassic Park, probably. But anyway, I had a little talk with him electronically, and he said he's going to be around here a little later on.
Hey, do you guys want to see Santa Claus?
Yes!
Yeah!
All right.
You know that opening shot with the line?
Yes.
I would say that was a line share.
You're right, of fame. Yeah. Well, we do have a fun-filled hour ahead of us. Hope you'll stick around and enjoy. It's a great way to kick off your holiday weekend. Here's a look at some of the fun we've got ahead of us.
I'm Alan Johnson in a crowded shopping mall parking lot in Moncton. This scene is being repeated all over the Maritimes today, and it will be again tomorrow. We'll examine the last-minute shopping rush coming up on Live at 5.
I'm Janet Stewart at the Halifax International Airport, where Maritime families are being reunited for Christmas. I'll bring you the magic later on Live at 5.
This is Adam.
Hi, Adam.
Yeah, he was born on Tuesday.
And also ahead this evening, a little Christmas grace. We'll drop in on a maritime hospital where there is just one beautiful miracle this special time of year.
All this and much more ahead on this very special edition of Live at 5. Right now we're checking in with Steve Murphy, working on the ATV Evening News at 6.
Thanks, Nancy. Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas, everyone. A couple of hunters have stumbled onto a grisly discovery here in the Maritimes today. They found a decomposed body in the woods in the Glace Bay area. Police are now trying to bring in forensic experts to conduct testing on the remains. Question is, whose body is it and how did it end up here? We have the story coming up at 6 o'clock tonight. Also on your evening news, a 17-year-old American will be tried for murder in adult court. The youth is charged in the death of Troy Frazier last August. He was working alone at his dad's gas station when he was shot and killed. More on this important court ruling today at 6 o'clock. Also this.
Pop, and I come down and there was water coming out of the drainage hole for the town, just coming out and hitting the other wall and within.
And it will be a muddy Christmas indeed for about a dozen maritime families. Big water main break in Summerside has caused serious flooding and tens of thousands of dollars in damage. Just look at the mess here. Terrible way to spend the holidays. These folks are trying to cope. We've got their story ahead tonight here at 6 o'clock. Right now, it's time for our first fast look at the maritime weather forecast. Over to that jolly old elf, meteorologist Steve Weigel from the ATV Weather Center tonight, Steve.
Thank you, Steve. It's shaping up to be a very warm holiday weekend. We have some rain on the way, too. It'll get here overnight and continue for tomorrow. I'll give you all the details on the wet weather coming up later in the show. Steve.
Okay, thank you, Steve. The Weigel weather for you at 5:30, then at 6 o'clock, all the day's top stories, including another tale of goodwill at Christmas time. Yes, another pleasant Christmas picture, a tree and presents. But yeah, this is a picture that could have appeared a lot less rosy were it not for some genuine Christmas goodwill. It's a Christmas disaster averted. It becomes a Christmas miracle tonight on the ATV Evening News at 6 o'clock, right after the very special Christmas edition of Live at 5. And it's back to Bill and Nancy and friends.
Thank you, Steve, very much. It is a feel-good Friday. And first at 5 tonight, we've got festivities, fun, and some pretty fast shopping.
And Nancy, there's tonight.
Mm-hmm.
There is tomorrow. And that's it for this year's Christmas shopping season. So, the last-minute panic button has been taking a beating from shopping stragglers in our region. And are you one of them?
I certainly am. And ATV's Alan Johnson was out among them today. Alan, how was it?
Well, it was busy. And I'd have to say, judging from my day in the malls, guys, that maritime retailers are going to have to hire extra staff in the new year just to count all the extra profits from this Christmas shopping season.
Shoppers were counting their blessings just to get into the parking lot at New Brunswick's largest shopping mall today. And once they got in, parking was a tight squeeze.
Normally we park up handy to the building, but here we are out
pretty near to the main street, and it's very crowded.
And inside, the story's the same.
Who do you have left to buy for?
My family.
The whole family?
No, just some of my brothers and my sisters.
Who are you buying for?
My mother and my sister.
And what about you?
I'm buying for Laura and Sean and my family.
And how about you?
I'm just buying for my friends.
For some people, walking through a crowded mall like this can be a lot of fun. For others, it's a pre-Christmas hassle. It all depends on your frame of mind and how much preparation you've put into it.
There's certain times of the day that you can go by, and there's certain shortcuts you can get through parking lots and stuff that people don't realize, especially to get here.
So it's all in the practice.
Oh, yeah. Well, if you've been doing it for 15 or 20 years, you get to know the shortcuts and around.
You know, just picking up last-minute things, gift wrap and tape and stuff like that.
Everyone seems to be in a pretty good mood.
Yeah, it's time of the year, I guess, eh?
I like to be in the mall this time of year anyways.
Why's that?
Well, see all the decorations and everybody shopping, and, you know, it's a lot of fun.
So there you have it, Nancy. Life is what you make it, and I guess in this case, Christmas shopping is what you make it. So it's all in the attitude.
You're right, I always have fun. Now, you talked to a few retailers today. What were they saying with just a couple days to go?
Well, you know, I tried to talk to as many as I could, and they're telling me that Moncton is a good indicator of the entire Maritimes because we draw shoppers here from PEI and Nova Scotia, and they're saying this is one of their best years in about 20 years. So it looks like a really good Christmas shopping season for retailers, and the shoppers, as we just saw, don't seem to mind it at all.
All right, that gives us all reason to celebrate. Thanks a lot, Alan. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas to you.
Have a great one. And we're going to hear from the Nova Scotia Mass Choir in just a moment. First, our very own mall crawler, Bill.
Now, Nancy, where do you think Janice Landry should be at this time of evening on Live at 6 minutes out? Is she in editing or writing a script? No. Our Janice Landry is out in a mall. Janice, what's going on?
Bill, is there any dough where I'd be this time of night? I'm not ready. Nobody's ready. And in the mall, I'm down live here at Scotia Square. I'm in the $123 store where everybody'd like to be because it's the store where you can get lots of stocking stuffers and whatnot. I'm here with Joanne, who's going to be our host for the evening, and she's going to show us some of the stuff. Joanne, what's selling hot this year?
Well, our greatest seller is the talking parrot.
Okay, show us the parrot. Turn it on. Turn it on now.
Here it is. Great little machine. It repeats every word you say.
ATV. It's just like you and me, Joanne. It just goes on and on forever. Okay, yes. Turn that off. Something else now. What about over here in these little boxes right down here?
Oh.
What's this?
Handcuffs.
Handcuffs?
Yes, great stocking stuffer this year. Everybody's been buying them.
Okay, let's leave those alone. This is a family show, mind you. What else? Move along now. Anything else you can think of around
unicorns?
Here? Unicorns.
Unicorns are selling great.
So what is it? Is it the cheap? Is it the cheap things, the stocking stuffers?
Yes, cheap things and stuff up to $3-4.
Okay, who's in here tonight? Everybody thinks it's going to be men out here today, the last minute. Is there a lot of ladies? I see a lot of ladies
men
in the store right now.
Ladies and kids, actually. There's a lot of kids picking up $20 worth of stocking stuffers. That's incredible.
And me too, because I'm not finished. As you can see, the lineup at the cash register. Yeah. Anyway, we're going to check back in a little later. Right now, we're going to go back to Nancy and Bill, who are standing by with the choir. We're going to hear their first song. Guys?
That's right, Jan. Thanks a lot. We are here with some of the members of the Nova Scotia Mass Choir. Delighted to have you guys here.
Delighted to be here.
Yeah. What's your first number?
Silent Night.
Okay. Can I sing along?
Sure.
I don't think I should. I'll let you handle it. Go for it. Can't wait.
Oh, The stars are brightly shining. It is the night of the dear Savior's birth.
My name is Joe Hollis. I'd just like to wish Merry Christmas. I only have family in St. John, but I also know I have grandparents in Halifax and in Cape Breton. I know a guy named Rob who sent me a Christmas present. Thank you very much.
Hi, my name is Bill Allen. I'd like to wish Merry Christmas to my brother Donnie and his wife Joanne, Christy and Scotty. Merry Christmas. Bye.
Hi, I'm Sonia Hart in St. John in the City Market. I'd like to say a very Merry Christmas to my family, and I'll see you Christmas Eve.
My name is Mary Roberts, and I'd like to say a Merry Christmas to all the Roberts in Fredericton. Hi, Graham.
Hi, my name is Jill Hattie, and I'd like to wish a very Merry Christmas to my oldest friend, Tina, and her husband, Mark, Blizzard, and their family in Fredericton.
My name is Camille Kehoe, co-owner of Fat Freddy's Fries, and I'd like to say Merry Christmas to all our friends in the Maritimes and everybody I've ever met from the West Coast to the East Coast. Merry Christmas.
What a fly.
Hi, I'm Rob Campbell. I'd like to wish Mike and Kim Maynard in Trenton, Ontario, a very, very Merry Christmas.
Hi, my name is John Keel, and I'd like to wish Merry Christmas to all my relatives in Cape Breton and to all our friends and customers here in St. John.
Merry Christmas.
And a Happy New Year.
All right, ooh, folks all over the region.
We've got a lot of anchors tonight.
That's right. Hey, does anybody here want to say Merry Christmas to somebody?
I'd like to say Merry Christmas to my nanny and Poppy.
Okay, hey. And this was the first hand up.
I like to say Merry Christmas to my mom and my dad.
Give a wave into the camera there. There you go.
I like to say Merry Christmas to my brother Morgan.
Is he at home?
Yep, he's watching.
All right.
I like to say Merry Christmas to my friend Leland.
All right, Leland. Who else?
I like to say Merry Christmas to my best friend Diane.
All right. And Dougie back there?
I like to say Merry Christmas to my sister.
Good. All right.
That young lady right there looks at her hand.
I'd like to say Merry Christmas to my friend Anne. Sackville, I think it was, and Merry Christmas to my other friend, Brent.
Right.
All right. And?
Hi, my name's Brooke, and I would like to say Merry Christmas to my mom and my daddy and my two aunts.
Brooke, who's your daddy?
Stuart.
Stuart Cameron. Dr. Stuart Cameron, give a wave to that camera, would you? All right. Everybody else will have a chance to say Merry Christmas to somebody later, all right? Okay.
All right. Listen now, Christmas miracles come in all shapes and all sizes, right?
Mm-hmm.
And they are miracles. Now, we're going to, how about going to the International Airport?
I think that's a great idea. It is the largest,
the largest airport in the region. Today, and a lot of things magical and miraculous happen at an airport. Let's take a look at it.
Thank you.
I'm sorry.
Yeah.
I couldn't believe it. Where did you go?
Well, I was on one of the small planes, so we came in the other way, so I don't know.
Oh, he's been away a year, and he's teaching in the Yukon, and we're just thrilled to have him home. Haven't seen him for a year. So, I can't believe I'm crying. John, get over here.
There, you want to give her a kiss?
Buying a ticket isn't always the hard part of getting home for Christmas.
I left it 4 o'clock yesterday, Yukon time, so it's 4 hours difference, but it's like 17 hours it took because I paid late, so.
Sure, Santa's workshop may be a special place, but airports are where Christmas dreams are really made. A perfect place for a father-daughter reunion.
Haven't seen her like quite a while now, and
I've been away, right, and I just got here and all that kind of stuff, and just great to have her here, and it's going to be a great Christmas.
Steve!
Want to say hi?
Hey, hi, Steve!
Hi!
Have you flied on an airplane?
Wow. And of course, Christmas reunions are for kids of all ages. Dean Cutting and his wife flew in from northern Quebec.
You must be glad to have them back, aren't you?
You bet. You bet. Can't wait for them to come. Just dread the day they have to go back.
Does it make your Christmas?
Oh, it sure does.
Tim Malik thought his daughter should have a maritime Christmas.
Does it make Christmas more special?
It will. It'll be the first one in 10 years, so I hope so.
First one home.
First one home. Yeah.
Maritimes is great to come home to. Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas to you too.
At the Halifax International Airport, Janet Stewart, ATV News.
Hey, that makes you feel good, doesn't it?
Oh, yeah. Whatever.
And when we come back, the conclusion to our Live at 5 tour of cultural Christmas celebrations in the Maritimes.
That's right, Nancy. Down on the farm, Maritime Christmas is next on Live at 5. Stay with us. We'll be right back.
It's the most wonderful time of the year.
I would like to say Merry Christmas to my daddy, who's going to be away from us this Christmas.
Who do you want to wish Merry Christmas to?
Grampy and Grammy and Nanny.
I like to wish Ryan Faulkner a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
He's a friend of yours?
Yes, he's a friend of mine.
Well, that's very nice. You have a nice Christmas too.
Yeah, you too.
Thank you.
All my grandparents. All my grandparents too.
And where do they live?
CI Road.
Merry Christmas to everybody, and especially to all of those little kids.
From everyone at the Low Tide and all our friends on the Miramichi, we'd like to wish you a very Merry Christmas and a prosperous New Year.
I don't know, my fiance, Lori McDonald, and all these fine people to bring these parcels in so I can have a job.
Welcome back to Live at 5. Some folks on the Miramichi offering up holiday greetings. And as you know, for the past 2 weeks, we've been highlighting different ethnic traditions at Christmas here in the Maritimes. Tonight, in our final segment, ATV's Janice Landry looks at a Maritime Christmas.
And she joins us live again from where else but a shopping mall.
Okay, pick on me, guys. But, you know, most of us get a few days off at the holiday season to spend with our loved ones. I decided to take you to a place that they don't give any a break. Not even on Christmas Day.
A down-on-the-farm Christmas at Oaklawn Farm and Zoo in Aylesford, Nova Scotia. The work doesn't stop here, not even on Christmas Day.
You're their family as much as they're your family.
That's right, and it's not even like children. With children, at least there's a stage when children grow up and can be on their own, but with animals, they're always dependent on you, and they're always your responsibility.
Even on Christmas Day?
Even on Christmas Day.
Go get it. Get it! Get it!
Here, the animals are very much part of the family. The young ones even get Christmas presents. I had the honor of giving Jerry the baby jaguar his.
Hey. Yeah, that's what I really want.
This is my new dog. Nobody's bugging me in the neighborhood. I got a lion. Come on, Esther. Come on.
She likes the dog. Yeah, she just loves them.
Incredibly, many of the animals are friends and have no fear of each other.
They're not at all nervous of each other.
No.
Is that just through time, or?
It's just because she's been down here and talked to the bear, and I mean, there's no reason for animals to be aggressive toward one another unless they're fighting for food or space, which they aren't. Sit. 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 That's a boy.
Gail even convinced me to feed Smokey the bear a candy cane. You have to have trust in the caregiver and the animal.
Smokey. Came off the Smoky Mountain at St. Margaret's Bay.
Perhaps the most amazing part of the day comes when Gail gets in the cage with Azzy, one of the biggest cats.
Oh,
a cat that looks more like a kitten than the king of the jungle.
Yeah. Yeah. You're the baby. Four.
So you have no fear in there at
but
all?
I have no fear. If I had fear inside me now, I would be in trouble. It would be like a cat with a mouse, that kind of thing. He would, you know how anything that runs gets chased?
Yes.
Same on a schoolyard with kids. The child who runs in fear is going to be chased.
Love and respect between owners and animals. You'll find it here at Oaklawn Farm every day of the year.
There are other people there.
Now, Bill, I have to tell you how much I enjoyed doing that story. I'm sure you could tell by watching it. It was a lot of fun. I want to thank the Rogersons of Oaklawn Farm in Aylesford, Nova Scotia. Christmas Day there is very unusual. Their daughter, Eva, comes down from Halifax and cooks the Christmas dinner, which helps them out. And what they do is they each open up a present. They have to go outside and do a chore, come back in, get warmed up, and go back out. And Bill, it's kind of a whole day-long process because, as I said earlier, the work never stops there.
Janice, that's a great story, but you know the role. Reporter involvement. How come you didn't get in the cage and give that big pussycat a kiss?
Well, look, Bill, I gave the bear a candy cane.
Oh,
game. What
sure.
Do you expect? Give me a break. That thing stands 7 feet tall.
He was purring there.
It was a great time, Bill.
Good story. Thanks, Janice.
You're welcome.
Nancy.
Thank you, Bill. We've got lots of help here tonight. I want to introduce you to Graham Denman. He's been on this show how many years running?
Six.
Since you were about this high, anyway. And do you want to tell them what your dad does at ATV?
He is master control operator.
That's right. And you're going to do something right now for us, aren't you?
Yeah, I'd like to introduce the members of the Nova Scotia Mass Choir.
All right.
Was in the moon of winter time when all the birds had fled, that mighty Michiganatoo sent angel choirs instead. Before the night, stars grew dim, and wandering hunters heard the hymn. Jesus, your King is born. Jesus is born in excelsis gloria. O children of the forest free, O sons of Manitou, Holy Child of earth and heaven was born for me and you. Come kneel before the radiance boy who brings us peace, love, and joy.
Let's use that as background for our holiday milestones to tell you about tonight.
That's right. We'll start off, Nancy, with Mr. and Mrs. Alfred Sear of Grand Falls, New Brunswick. They're marking their 50th anniversary today, celebrating at the Trade Dock. Love and best wishes from their 7 children, 16 grandchildren, and 2 great-grandchildren. And we also have a special greeting going out today to Leon and Marion Rushton of Oxford, Nova Scotia. They have 6 children and 4 grandchildren who send them their love today, right?
Today is also 50 years together for Clarence and Nellie Mitchell of Porter's Lake, Nova Scotia. Congratulations from their family and friends. Also celebrating today, Irvin and Teresa Carr of Geary, New Brunswick. Their 3 children and 6 grandchildren would like to extend congratulations on their 50 wonderful years together.
Also, the family of Benny and Hilda Perry of Clyde River, Nova Scotia, wish them all the best on their golden anniversary today. And today is 50 years together for Richard and Dorothy Vesey of Charlottetown. They're celebrating with their family and friends, including 4 children, 8 grandchildren, and 1 great-grandchild at the open house at the CP Hotel. Congratulations.
And for Christmas Eve, we have one milestone to tell you about. Meet Mr. and Mrs. Ivan Dagley of Conquerel Mills, Nova Scotia, who are definitely in the holiday spirit. They're celebrating on December 29th with an open house at the Italy Cross Fire Hall. And if you are doing more than the usual celebrating in your life today or tomorrow, over the weekend, anytime, all the best from everybody here in the newsroom.
Absolutely, and a Merry Christmas to all of them.
You're here. And there's lots more to come in the second half of Live at 5, including more from the members of the Nova Scotia Mass Choir.
And we're going to enjoy them right now, right?
Yes, more music, and we also have this story still ahead.
Right.
I'm Heather Proudfoot at the Grace Maternity Hospital in Halifax. Here they know how to keep Christmas well. A touch of Christmas at the Grace later in the show.
And when we return, Merry Meteorology. Steve Wiggles got the complete holiday weekend weather forecast when Live at 5 continues. Stay with us.
Hi, my name is Dax McLean, and I'd like to say Merry Christmas to my grandfather and my parents, mom and dad.
My name is Michelle Cassidy, and I'd like to say Merry Christmas to my parents and all my relatives.
Hi, my name is Eve Daigle, and I want to wish Merry Christmas to all my friends in Nakataville.
Hi, my name is Raja Karmia, and I want to wish Merry Christmas to my family in Newfoundland and all around here in Moncton.
Hi, my name's Dave. Merry Christmas to everybody.
My name is Brenda Roberts, and we'd like to wish everyone a Merry Christmas, all our friends and relatives. And I'd like to say hi to my mother's in the hospital in Moncton.
Hi, my name is Natalie Debnon, and I'd like to wish a Merry Christmas to my mom, dad, and my sister Sophie.
Hi, my name is Jalen Thériault. I would like to wish a Merry Christmas to everybody, my friends, and my family.
Hi, my name is Todd Gilroy. I'd like to wish Merry Christmas to my mom and dad in Moncton and all my friends back in Truro.
Hi, my name is Marlene, and I just wanted to wish a very Merry Christmas to Cindy and Wayne Grantham and family in Lower Sackville, Nova Scotia.
My name is Philios LeBlanc, and Merry Christmas and Happy New Year to Bernie Godet in St. Joseph.
Hi, my name is Tabitha Roy, and I'd like to wish Merry Christmas to my mom and my sister and my father in Bathurst.
All right, lots of Christmas spirit out there, and you know what? I don't think it can even be dampened by some really wet weather.
But it's going to be wet.
It's a good thing. Here's Steve Wiegel.
Santa and his reindeer are going to get wet tomorrow. Yes, there is a big rainstorm on its way up to the eastern seaboard. In fact, the showers have already started in the Liverpool area, and that'll change to rain overnight and spread across the Maritimes from the southern areas to the northern areas during the night. We've still got mild temperatures, though. In fact, this is going to turn out to be one of the mildest winters right across Canada, with the jet stream well above the international border. Here's the latest satellite photo. You can see a lot of cloud pushing up the eastern seaboard. Got a bit of a ridge now starting to break up with another low pressure system up to our north and a bit of a ridge back to the west. And this ridge will push in for later on the long weekend. So we're expecting that by later Sunday and Monday, we'll be back to the sunshine and mild temperatures. It looks pretty nice, in fact. Here's a close-up of the Maritimes, and you can see a lot of cloud and precipitation just to our south right now. The leading edge of that cloud is now well up into northern New Brunswick. We'll continue to push northward in the next 24 hours. And we will see the rain begin in the next few hours. We've already, as I mentioned, have a report of a shower through the Liverpool area. That'll spread rain, and there is a chance of light snow overnight through southern and western areas of the Maritimes, and that'll quickly change over to rain. So it could be an hour or two of slippery driving out there, about 1 to 2 a.m. Here's the last 24 hours. What a change we've had in the last 24 hours. Big system continues to push up from the north or from the south. And increasing cloud during the day. We saw a bit of sunshine and nice temperatures out there. By tomorrow, I think the low will be right on top of us with the rain embedded in that system. The low will continue to give us rain during the day. That will taper to showers later in the day. And then by tomorrow night, we've still got the showers, very mild temperatures, and then the low begins to push out. Sunshine is expected later on Christmas Day, so it's looking pretty good right now with the warm temperatures, and that will continue right into Boxing Day as the high-pressure system pushes in. So overnight, here's what we have. Generally cloudy out there, and we'll see the rain after midnight push into the Maritimes, and there is a chance of that being light snow, especially where you see the temperatures hover around the zero mark through Fredericton and Moncton, around Antigonish, and up through Sydney. Be a quick change over to rain, though, as temperatures begin to rise as the warm front approaches. Very cool up in northern New Brunswick, -4 and -6. Gusty winds overnight. This is a real nor'easter. Wind gusts up to 60 and 70 kilometers an hour. So take care on the roads. There is a travel advisory out. With the black ice, the temperatures dropping, we could really see some slick roads out there. Then tomorrow, the rain tapers to showers later in the day. We have a wind warning out for the western side of the Cape Breton Highlands with wind gusts up to 100 kilometers an hour. The rain will taper off during the day, and temperatures, look at this, +9 in other western and southern areas of Nova Scotia, and we're looking at 3 and 5 across northern areas of New Brunswick. And then for the big day, Christmas Day, we have a chance of a shower in the morning and then sunshine in the afternoon and very warm, and then lots of sunshine for Monday, Boxing Day, and Tuesday. Guys.
All right, thanks a lot, Steve. I've got a few helpers here. How are you doing?
Good.
What do you want for Christmas?
TV, telephone.
Holy cow, what do you want for Christmas?
Flash screen.
All right. Do you guys think there's any chance that Santa Claus might come here today?
Yeah.
What could we sing? What could we sing to make him come? Let's do it. Can we sing that? Let's sing it. All right. Let's see if it'll work. See if we can convince Santa Claus to drop into the studio. Go for it. But everybody has to sing. Here we go. What do you know? Hey, that's Alexander. Santa, welcome.
Hello, Nancy.
I'm so glad. I'm so glad you had time to stop in to see us today.
Oh, I just came in by helicopter. Just a quick trip. I'm so busy.
Now, do you have your own personal helicopter?
Oh, yes. Oh, yeah. I got my own helicopter, yeah.
Well, is there anyone, any good boys and girls who you might want to say Merry Christmas to?
Oh, well, there's Uncle Santa got a little list here. He'd like to, he's checking it to make sure everybody was naughty and nice. All kinds of boys and girls here. Oh, my
Santa
gracious.
Santa wants to say Merry Christmas to a couple people.
Oh,
a couple people.
Keisha. I think Keisha Timmons, I think it is. Justin and Courtney McIntosh.
Oh, Aisha's down there.
And,
Aisha, you want to say hi to Santa? You want to say hi to Santa?
Hi.
Hi, dear. How are you?
Do you know who this guy is? Who is that, Aisha?
You know.
All of a sudden, she's shy. All right, Live at 5 continues in just a moment. Coming up next, some Christmas miracles.
Juliana.
No,
Juliana Francis.
Baby Beat when Live at 5 returns. Stay with us.
Jingle bell, jingle bell, jingle bell rock. Jingle bell swing and jingle bell ring. Snowing and blowing up bushels of fun. Now the jingle.
That's the harbor, right? It is the harbor. Oh, what a beautiful Christmas setting. While Santa Claus is talking with the children, it gives me an opportunity to wish Steve Murphy.
Yes, indeed.
Merry Christmas.
Yeah, very nice to have you here with us on the, I guess, it's the Christmas Eve show.
Yes, I've done a lot of these over my time.
I'll bet you have. Well, you've probably...
enjoying it, though. It's
can we digress for a minute?
Absolutely. What's that?
The days...
Looking back?
Yeah, well, I was going to say the days when you, of course, were... leading the crusades at CJCB in Sydney.
Sydney, yes.
Yeah, and I seem to recall hearing you and Santa Claus reading letters together, don't I?
Way, way back,
Way back. Here's what's coming up in a few minutes at your ATV Evening News tonight, 6 o'clock. Quite a shock for a couple of maritime hunters today. Their hunt for rabbits interrupted by the discovery of human remains,
right,
a macabre find made in the woods near Glace Bay. Now the grim task of identifying the remains. The latest is coming up tonight at 6 o'clock. Also, do you hear what most people hear, which in New Brunswick government buildings is nothing? The workers are all gone, taking unpaid leave. Some say the cost-cutting measures could prove to be a real pain for anybody who wants to deal with government over the next few days. That story coming up here at 6 o'clock. And also, a young maritimer wants to give back the gift of life in order to return a precious favor. Last year, Gary Kingsley needed blood to get him through, and now he's giving the gift of life. The story coming up tonight on the ATV Evening News at 6 o'clock. Right after Live at 5, which continues now. Back to Nancy.
Thank you very much, Steve. Workplaces can be a lot of fun at this time of year. I guess this gathering is proof of that. Another place they have a lot of fun at this time of year is the Grace Maternity Hospital in Halifax, where they share some very special traditions with their very special patients. And today, ATV's Heather Proudfoot was given a glimpse of Christmas at the Grace.
Bright and early this morning, it began with a staff carol sing, harmony compliments of the maintenance staff.
Well, we do quite a bit of singing in the hospital over Christmas. Our whole maintenance group sings quite often, every day, pretty well through the Christmas season.
So the singing maintenance men?
Well, yeah, we've been called worse than that, but yeah, that's better.
Is this kind of a fun hospital to work in at Christmas time?
Oh, yeah. It's a, like a family.
Yeah, it's great. It's a family atmosphere. And
a maternity hospital, they say, can be a wonderful and an interesting place at Christmas time. Babies don't stop for the holidays.
It's a lovely atmosphere this time of the year.
So we were given a tour, first to the feeding room. Tiny Juliana, barely 5 pounds, will be staying here over Christmas.
Gets a little more weight on her, and we get her eating a little bit better, we'll get her home, maybe for New Year's.
But the Robertsons will make the best of it. In between Juliana's feedings, they'll duck out for Christmas dinner. Still others are playing the waiting game, the ultrasound room.
This is probably going to be a New Year's baby, huh?
Or Christmas Eve.
Christmas Eve.
This is not the place I expected to be 2 days before Christmas.
So you're waiting and waiting?
And waiting and waiting. We're anxious now. We're past our date, so we're ready to have a baby any time now.
And still others have lucked out, timing-wise. In this room, they're packing up to bring their bundle of joy home for Christmas. Meet 7-pound, 4-ounce Adam and his mother, Linda Ellis.
It was one of my biggest concerns was that we wouldn't get home for Christmas. I have a 4-and-a-half-year-old at home, and she's very excited to meet her little brother.
And for those babies who did arrive in time for Christmas, a very special tradition for them. Since 1957, Grace babies delivered during the Christmas season are hand-delivered back to mom in a Christmas stocking.
We wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
In Halifax, Heather Proudfoot, ATV News.
All right, thank you, Heather. And the party continues here. Who do you want to say Merry Christmas to?
Say Merry Christmas to all my family and friends.
All right.
To my dad, my cat, and my Aunt Marion.
Your cat. And who do you want to introduce now?
The Nova Scotia Mass Choir.
Here we go again. Merry Christmas, everybody.
Yeah, I want to wish a Merry Christmas to all my old customers from St. Mary's University, the barbershop. All best. I still are thinking of you. I go back in Italy the next month, and in my heart, I carry you with me.
Merry Christmas, Lita. Here I am at the mall doing some shopping, last minute shopping for you and the kids. I'd
like to wish all the guys in the Navy a Merry Christmas, especially those on Terranova and the ones in Toronto and the Gulf.
Merry Christmas.
I'm Susan Harris from Halifax, and I'd like to say Merry Christmas to my parents in Yarmouth.
And I'd like to say Merry Christmas to my grandmother, Nana Warren, in PEI.
Kenny Reed, I'd like to say Merry Christmas to Grandma and Mom and Dad.
Oh, I'd like to wish all my people and relatives and Grandma and Nana Merry Christmas. And Maxwood also.
Susan, and I want to say Merry Christmas to my Mom and Dad, and my husband Stephen and his parents Vincent, Florence, and Michelle and Paul, and Greg and Gerald and Joey and Jackie and Paula and Dave. Did I already say them? Okay, and my nanny. All right.
That's a lot of folks she wanted to say hello to. We have some more people that want to say Merry Christmas to some folks they know. I want to introduce you to some people who actually work here at ATV. Jerry, would you like to say Merry Christmas to anyone?
I just like to say Merry Christmas to everyone, my family and friends everywhere.
Are you nervous?
Just a little bit. So please leave. No.
Okay, thank you very much. He's in charge of the audio. He could cut my microphone off at any moment. Now I'm going to get everybody. in here to introduce themselves and say Merry Christmas to someone.
Hi, I'm Derek Simmons. I do auto cue here, and Merry Christmas to my wife and to all my friends and family in Nova Scotia.
Yeah, he's a newlywed.
You have a minute and a half, hon.
Thank you.
This is my niece, Miranda. Miranda.
Hi, Miranda.
She's a Moyes. This is my other side of my family. I'd like to say Merry Christmas to the Moyses and the Sweets. And she's my helper. She helps me count backwards from 10.
And Natalie's pregnant. We just found out today. She's expecting. Sorry, I had to spill the beans. Now, this is the big boss in the control room right now.
Hi, Nance. Hi, I'm Vicki Bowe, and I'd like to wish Merry Christmas to all my family in the Valley, Mom and Dad and Nanny. And Mom, I'm bringing the boys home for Christmas. I hope that's not a problem.
Oh,
I didn't mention it before.
The cats. Ooh. Cat fur
cats
everywhere.
Cats being chaplain.
I can tell you. Now, do you want to give us a quick demonstration of what you do in here,
okay,
Vicki, as the director?
Well, on the preview shot now, which we're not going to, that would have the next shot that we're going to up there.
There's Bill.
There's Bill. We would be going to Bill.
Okay.
And then I would say standby camera 2 and take camera 2. And we'd be up on Bill, and Bill would intro the next thing, which is Janice back down at Scotia Square.
But the switcher over here wasn't paying attention, so we didn't go up on Bill.
No, well, I'm the real boss, so you notice it didn't happen.
That's
so
right. Dale, anybody you want to say Merry Christmas to?
Yeah, my daughter's out there in the studio, so I'd like to wish Merry Christmas to my other daughter and my little boy Lee, who are probably
right
home watching their sister.
Terrific, and we're going by you here.
Hi, my name is James Nickerson. I do auto cue here. I don't even know what the job I'm doing here anymore. I do Chiron, and I wish Merry Christmas to my family. And if you're not good, I'll spell your name wrong.
Okay, I'll be good. And this is a very special friend of ours, David Cable.
Hi, thank you, Nancy. To Mom and Dad.
There you
and
go.
To all my family that's here in Halifax, I want to wish you the very best.
And a Merry Christmas, right?
Merry Christmas to all my family.
Give them a big smile, Dave.
And a big hello to all my friends.
All right, we've got one more person to introduce you to right back here, the technical producer, Jody Jassim. How are you doing, Jody?
Good, Nance. How are you?
Good. You have some kids at home probably watching you right now.
Sammy and Alex. Merry Christmas to my wife, Jeannie. And I'd like to say hello to everybody in Cape Breton, especially my mother and father and my in-laws, Harold and Esther. Merry Christmas, everybody in Cape Breton.
All right. You think we should throw over to Bill now?
Yeah. Back to you, Bill. Mr. Jassim.
Thank you, Mr. Jassim. Well, the clock is ticking away, but Janice Landry is using every second that she can muster because she's still in the malls. Janice?
Well, Bill, I am in the mall. And see this? See the stressed out look in my eyes? There's a lot of people in the mall looking this way. Now, if you've got somebody on your list that's really hard to buy for, I have found the perfect thing. In fact, I hear from Steve Wiggle that we're supposed to get rain on Christmas Day. So, Neelam, we're here at the Handloom Boutique in Scotia Square Live. You have something for that rainy Christmas. Show me what it is.
Well, if you want some rain, take this, turn it over.
That's so cool.
Rain. Yeah.
What is it?
Well, these are made out of cactus, and the thorns are pushed inwards. And then there's pebbles inserted, so when they fall, they cascade around the thorns and make the sound.
Okay, I got just your helper over here is Angela. And Angela, you work in a store, and you haven't started your Christmas shopping?
No, I haven't started yet. I've been working too hard, I guess.
Yeah, like me. You better get out there. Are you going to go right after work?
No, I have things to do tonight, so it's going to be Christmas Eve shopping for me.
You're out tomorrow. Yeah. Well, I'll probably be out tomorrow myself. I still have lots to do, guys. I got to get going, so Merry Christmas to everybody, and I'll see you guys tomorrow night on the 6 o'clock news. Bye-bye. Got to go. Merry Christmas,
bye-bye,
Janice.
Bye-bye, Janice. Merry Christmas. Did a great job. I
that's
hope you got
right
my gift. Who's this? Hey.
This,
the heart of the show.
Right? That's right. Oh. Kirk Neff is our floor director. He never gets the spotlight, but tonight, here it is, shining on you.
I know.
Who do you want to say Merry Christmas
to? I'd like
to
wish my little boy, Brody, Merry Christmas, and you guys, too.
Okay. What do you want us to do now? He's the one that bosses us around behind the cameras.
I guess we're going to have to wrap up. And throw it a bumper.
You want to say Merry Christmas to Lee and Keith on camera,
too?
Oh,
yeah. I'll throw it to my boys.
All right.
Keith, Merry Christmas, Lee.
Live time continues in just a moment with the wake-up weather. Please,
great stuff.
Stick around.
Rudolph the red-nosed reindeer had a very shiny nose. And if you ever saw it, you would even...
Canadian maritime history, commemorating a voyage that changed the world. A Bristol shipyard is building a floating memorial to explorer John Cabot. The Matthew will set sail for Newfoundland in 1997. That story tonight on CTV News.
Well, Welcome back to Live at 5. The shopping mall in Douglastown was busy this afternoon with shoppers picking up those last-minute gifts and at the same time helping the less fortunate. On the Miramichi, volunteers from CFB Chatham wrapped gifts with all proceeds going to the local food banks. Last year, over $4,000 was raised, and that total will be surpassed this year. Isn't that terrific news?
Tremendous.
Yeah. Are you guys excited yet?
Yeah.
Oh, I guess we're excited, aren't we?
Yeah. All right, but you know what we need to find out before we get to singing again? We've got to find out exactly what the weather is going to be when we wake up tomorrow morning on Christmas Eve. Steve Wiggle, what have you got for us?
It will be warm inside and out, Nance, tomorrow with a warm front pushing through the Maritimes. A big weather system also moving up from the States. We've got a lot of rain associated with that. It'll start overnight tonight and then continue through Christmas Eve and taper off Sunday, being Christmas Day. And then we should see some sunshine for later on Christmas Day. Here's the close-up of the Maritimes. You can see lots of cloud and lots of precipitation down through the south. And this is all moving northward, so that in the next few hours we should see the rains begin in the southern areas of the Maritimes and then push northwards, and then by midnight we should see rain just about everywhere through southern and western Nova Scotia. So for the wake up tomorrow, lots of rain and windy out there, very mild though, 3 to 6 degrees, and the weather for the rest of the day looks pretty well, much the same in fact. Lots of rain, we'll taper to showers later in the day, and very warm temperatures up to 9 degrees in the southern and western regions of Nova Scotia. And guys, have a great Christmas.
All right, thank you, Steve, very much.
Thank you, everybody. We had a great time here today, and all be good boys and girls, and Santa will be around to see you on Christmas Eve.
You know what, Santa? I think all the boys and girls who are members of the Nova Scotia Mass Choir who came out at the last minute to help us out with our party today deserve
Christmas gift.
They deserve a lot of thanks. So are they going to get some presents?
Santa really enjoyed them, and they're going to get presents also, I guess.
All right. Thank you very much for being part of our party. We'll finish off with a rousing round of Go Tell It on the Mountain.
Nancy, tonight, sentenced. A maritime couple kills, but will not go to prison. Also tonight, grim discovery. Hunters find human
first
remains.
First thing I seen was the skull. So it's pretty hard to not know it wasn't human remains.
And guardian angel, a good Samaritan saves a family's Christmas.
It made Christmas for us, didn't it, Jack?
Merry Christmas.
From the number one news team in Atlantic Canada, the ATV Evening News.
Good evening, Merry Christmas. I'm Steve Murphy. A couple in Halifax has been handed a...
But now Mr. Maher has indicated that while his figures might be a little bit off this year, and he repeats this statement almost annually, within the next year or the next 2 years, look for a better showing. It's always down the road, and it's always after the next election.
Danny Cameron says many of Finance Minister Alan Maher's estimates involve speculation, not reality. All is quiet in the New Brunswick capital tonight. Most of the civil servants around the province are off for their extended Christmas holiday. But ATV's Laverne Stewart says the government claims it has made sure enough workers are on hand to deal with any real problems that come up.
Yep. I'm done for the holidays.
Yeah. Civil servants here in Fredericton and around New Brunswick began trickling out of office buildings at noon today. It will remain quiet here over the next 10 days. But some people say the lack of most civil servants in all government departments could mean hardships for some people.
And I think it's unfair. They could have done better. They could have used a different method, and they could learn to save some money during the year instead of doing this.
Thank you.
It's a poor way to wish everybody Merry Christmas.
There's going to be a lot of people that are going to be trying to get a hold of people, especially through times, the end of the month, where different checks are going out, different services are needed more times during then. that, yeah, it's definitely going to have an effect on our province.
But people who really need assistance can call a public inquiries number, and the government has put emergency workers in place in departments like transportation and human resources to deal with any problems that might come up over the next 10 days.
There are people in place to handle all emergencies or all situations that may require assistance.
The government believes most people will be celebrating the holidays and won't be interested in reaching government offices, and therefore the need for a normal civil servant staff load isn't necessary. Government offices in New Brunswick will be back in business January 3rd. In Fredericton, Laverne Stewart, ATV News.
Canada's postal workers call it the beginning of a new era of labor peace at the post office. Their union has just reached a tentative 30-month contract with Canada Post. The union says it got such a good deal in part because of what it calls a new spirit of cooperation with Canada Post's management.
There's improved job security, strong protections against contracting out, a wage increase for all postal workers, reduced work time through improved vacation leave and pre-retirement leave, there's job creation, there's same-sex postal benefits.
Now, if this deal is ratified, it will be the first time ever that a new contract is signed at the post office before the old one has expired. Still ahead in your ATV Evening News tonight, home for Christmas and then away again. But first to next, a gift literally from the heart, a Christmas miracle made to order.
Well, I was just walking between two parked cars and I saw this in huge wallet full of, completely full of money.
A holiday lost and found with a happy ending coming up next. Yeah.